Complexity science has a so-called holistic approach, meaning that it focuses on the global picture, the big picture, in contrast to traditional scientific approaches which are reductionists in the sense that they focus on the minor details, want to understand better and better how the fine details look like. And this latter approach has been extremely successful. So in physics, we understand how the molecules, the atoms, the particles look like. We know that there is a Higgs boson and all these things. And these are extremely important. Without them, we cannot understand the world. But now the question comes how to put together these fine and understood little details in order to make the entire system work. And here I should quote Anderson, a Nobel laureate, who said in a very short sentence, something very deep, more is different. So if we have many, many particles or many constituents, then there are new effects, then there are emergent effects which make the entire system so interesting and complex. I'm interested in what is called a scaffold of a complex system, which is the network. Every complex system, as I said, consists of many, many units which interact with each other. And this interaction creates a network which has very interesting properties, and without the understanding of this network, it is hopeless to understand the function of the entire system. So I'm focusing on understanding the topology of this underlying network. You can think of a society where people are in social contact with each other, and these social contacts create a social network. And all our communications or all our interactions happen on this social network. And its topology, the way how individuals are connected to each other, is crucial for the functioning of the network or for processes happening on the network. Such a process can be the spreading of a disease, or it can be spreading of information or spreading of an innovation. And these phenomena are in the focus of my research.